And welcome back to episode 3 of Red Dead Redemption 1, 11 year anniversary. Alright, I'll shut up and stop saying that now. We are here in Armadillo. Armadillo safe house above the saloon. With John Marston rocking the new deadly assassin outfit we unlocked in the last episode. We spoke with Nigel Dickens. He wants us to go meet up with his friend Seth. At Coots Chapel, so let's go. Alright, Nathan, let's go. We got our horse, Nathan, with a Y. You guys help me name him on Twitter. Sorry, dude. Sorry. My bad. Let me just share the stream real quick. Give me a quick sec. There we go. Got the stream shared. Come on. Come. I apologize for my dogs. This stranger right here. Do that eventually. Go. Rock this for a little while. Exhuming and other fine hobbies. Oh, brother.
Excuse me, are you Seth?
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Mr. West Dickens. My name's Marston. John Marston.
Goodbye, John Marston. It's been a great pleasure.
I need your help, Seth. We need your help. Me and Mr. West Dickens.
Let me be frank for 1 second, partner.
Come on in. Come on in, dog.
People. It was people who got me in this mess in the first place.
What mess?
Look at me. Look. Scrambling around, looking for maps, half insane. I ain't washed in 6 months. My hair falling out, my mind's going.
What happened?
What happened? My partner. He stole half my map. I never would have done that to him.
Oh.
Never. Look at me.
Who did this to you?
My partner. My boy, my man. Moses Ford. I don't have the facility to tell you what I would have done for that man. And what I would do to him now.
Why?
Because he stole half my goddamn map.
And what map's that?
Yeah, Johnny stole half the map.
The map that tells me where it is.
Try to keep up.
Where what is, friend?
I ain't telling you that.
The treasure. What else would a map lead you to? I guess, give you directions to a place, but still.
Sure. And where's this Moses now?
He's at Benedict Point. The law got him for exhuming. Some people, they feel differently. Not Moses. Him and me are the same. The self-same.
Come on, Seth. Let's go see Moses.
Yeah, come on,
get
Seth.
Your map back. Then maybe you'll help me.
All right, partner. Let's go. Horses are over here!
How much money do I even have? $1,400, okay.
Faster!
Let's go! How can you sink that low? Digging up graves and looting from the dead.
Ha, hypocrite! Yeah. The whole damn lot of you. Are you saying it's better to steal from the living? They're corpses. They don't care none.
These people have been laid to rest.
You don't know nothing. I talk to them long after they've been forgotten by every other fella. I tell them it's all right to be scared and alone.
How do you embrace them when they're stinking and rough?
I met some sick bastards in my time, Seth. But you, you're special.
Folk is cold and heartless all their lives. To me, they gets warmer when they're actually cold and heartless. Surely that makes sense to even you.
Not exactly, it don't.
Are we really living anyway? Do you exist outside my mind? Maybe we're both having the same dream, and when we wake up, we'll die.
I certainly seem to be in some kind of nightmare.
But is it undead? I see I did there.
Come on.
Undead nightmare reference.
Have you looked in the caves, Seth?
It's very dark.
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I just heard you say something.
You're a crazy man. You should get that head looked at.
Seth, I need someone who can get a wagon inside Fort Mercer. I was told you could help me, but I'm not sure you even know what day it is.
I don't. I can't even tell you what year it is.
I knew this was a
waste of time. 1911.
So, you want to go after Bill Williamson, do you?
You know Bill?
Oh, yes. I'm at Williamson and Deke, all them boys. Sometimes they call me on when they get some special job needs doing. I got a reputation as a man who'll do things most other fellers won't.
Now, that I can believe.
I reckon you can get in there, no bother. Assuming you help me find this map, that is.
Seth, you alright, man? Yeah, shake it off, you'll be fine.
Let's go! What's so important about this map?
Nothing much. Just unimaginable riches and such like. A spark of hope that lit a rage and fire I can't put out.
I thought as much. Another treasure hunter losing everything in the search for nothing.
Oh, I lost it all, partner. My wife, my children, my business. Good riddance to them all. I don't eat, I don't sleep, I don't wash, and I don't care.
I know.
Very open-minded.
I can smell you from here.
It used to be about the money, but now, I don't know who I am no more. I see myself, but it's like I'm looking at somebody else. Only it's me, you know?
Maybe it's time you moved on.
No way I can stop now. It's taking me over. There's no difference between night and day, just darkness. I want to see the sunshine again.
I've seen some candidates for Bedlam in my time, but you might just win the prize straitjacket.
This is it. Let's stop here a moment and come up with a plan. As far as I know, Moses is being held in that shack. There's a couple of deputies keeping guard outside. Can you distract him so I can sneak in for a quick parlay with that son of a bitch?
I'm sure I can think of something.
Okay.
Lead them away from the shack and out of sight. Somewhere out past that hill.
This is one god-awful assignment.
Are you looking for trouble, mister?
No.
Hey, what the hell? You are absolutely
oh god, let's run, John. I feel bad that we have to take this horse to Nathan, but no. I don't think Nathan will mind too much. I understand it's for a good reason.
Come on!
Thank you. So we steal a horse from a deputy, deliver them away from the shack, and then take the exact horse we stole back to where we came, back to where we stole it from. That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? I was like, mission failed. You injured Seth or something.
Now keep an eye out in case they come back. Moses? Oh, Moses! You got a visitor!
Oh my God, Seth! They arrested me. It weren't my fault. Ah! Get the hell away from me!
Get that slippery bastard! I need him alive, though!
Who the hell are you?
Hey, Ten. Come on, boy. Don't run over our target. Nathan, don't run away. At least we have the lasso unlocked.
What's this got to do with you?
Oh, I completely missed him. There we go. Took long enough.
Son of a bitch! Let me go! I'm begging you!
Language.
Whatever he told you, it's a lie.
Alright, where'd Nathan go? There you are, boy.
You must be
Nathan.
Stupid trusting that.
He's like, no, I don't like his language. She's like, no. He needs to watch his language
don't
and then I'll put him on the back.
Seth lost his mind.
Once put someone on the horse,
ago.
And John then said, shut up and don't annoy the horse.
You son of a bitch, let me go.
No.
Slow.
I'm quite okay to not do so.
Let's go.
There's a
Who do you
post.
Think you are, mister?
A concerned citizen.
You just wait till I get loose, mister.
I wish
just
that when you reach the epilogue in of RDR2, you could then get all of John's original outfits unlocked. It'd be cool. Like all of his outfits from RDR1 and
Moses.
his outfits from 1899.
Moses, you son of a bitch! Where's my damn map? Damn you, Seth! Damn you, Seth! You've always been a twisting little freak. I ain't telling you shit.
Then I'm gonna. Cut you up, piece by piece. Till you find your tongue.
Friend, this man has gone crazy in the sun. I suggest you take my advice and start talking.
Shut up, Marston. I want to cut into a bona fide man's flesh. Ain't never cut into a live one before.
Good God.
Oddfellow's rest. It's in Oddfellow's rest. Now, get away from me once and for all.
Well, ain't that a damn shame? I was starting to enjoy myself. I think you gone pissed yourself, Moses.
Those deputies went and put a bounty on your head. Best we clear it now. Don't need the law on our backs. I don't have no money, but I got me a pardon letter. Here, take it. You earned it for helping with the Moses. Come on. We can pay it off in the telegraph office. Come on, ain't no time to be wasting.
How'd my horse get on the porch?
Hello. That crazy Mary swears she seen.
I've got a pardon letter here.
You're in the clear now, but you be careful now. I'll see you soon. The body was.
So, mister, thanks for your help.
Don't worry yourself with thanks, Seth. Just help me when I come asking.
No problem, mister.
Yeah. How did the horse get over there? Alright, we'll go see Wes Dickens. He's over near Ridgewood Farm again. I just want to see what I need for outfits unlocked. Search Solomon's Folly, playing horse pick, breaking job at Ridgewood Farm. Let me open. Okay, defend residents of Troll Springs from Walton's gang, purchase at the Taylor and Thieves Landing. Search Thieves Landing, when horses in front of me, I watch out of Brown's Ranch. Defend residents of Hannigan's Stay from the Bullard Twins, claim a Bullard Twins gang bounty alive. Okay, I can do all that. Purchase at the Taylor and Thieves Landing. Okay. I can do all these eventually. So there's every gunsmith in the game. Execute 20 people. So to get an outfit and dress like a merchant, you need to execute 20 people. They're not what merchants did in their spare times. Oh, you son of a bitch!
You're a dead man!
You alright, horse? He's gone.
Let's go!
Well, why did I lose honor? He robbed from me to begin with. Whatever.
Can I borrow this, friend?
Horse pills.
Yeah!
Get the fuck out of me. Get the fuck out of me, is that what I'm saying? I think it scared the shit out of me. Creeped me the fuck out. Fucking scared me, I don't know. I hear the horse breaking job now. My Stickens' carriage is here. I do the horse breaking job so we can get it done while we're here.
I don't fancy your chances on this angry son of a gun. He's a wild one and no mistake.
Don't lasso the friggin' townsfolk, John.
Come on now! Just stay there! Easy! That's it!
I might prefer the horse breaking in RDR too.
Come on, come on, come on! Come on, baby! Calm down! Here we go! Calm down now!
There we go.
Come on!
Once did this and figuring I accidentally ran over a rancher and I failed the thing. What? What was the point of me jumping when the horses walked through it? Here we are.
Damn fine riding. That was fast work, son.
Thank you. $6. have another mission for Seth, but we'll do Nigel West Dickens' mission while we're here. Alton's gang, open menu entry updated. Oh, the carriage rides. I hate this one.
Ah, Mr. Marston. How are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. West Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on...
I can sort of pause between dick and ends, like, Egypt, you know, implying that calling him dick.
Valued more highly than literature?
Dickens.
I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
Of course.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull. Feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America... That lubricant with which we concern ourselves...
America.
...is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon. Extra hands. And... I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No, the sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating degenerate like myself can prosper. But come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive.
Now, sir, do gap tooth breach.
We'll skip to destination. Because from what I remember, there's no dialogue. There might be, but... I don't know. At least my horse followed me. Now, Nathan, don't take offense. It's just temporarily. Guys, I have to drive this carriage for the race, but still, just temporarily. I'm not looking forward to this. Stay there, boy. I prefer the carts handle, like the handling of the carts in Red Dead 2. Please have to watch the stamina for the horses on the carts in Red Dead 2. See, this is why I hate it. This is why I hate this mission. No fucking way! God. No. Let me just move the stream. Thing. John, it's right up there. Come on, we gotta beat this fucker. John, come on. Yep, this, I knew it. Yeah, you see, this is why I fucking hate this race. Because the fucking part where you go on the cart, and you gotta go that turn, it always fucks me over, and then the stamina for fucking cart horses. Oh, got this time. There we go.
Hell of a race, mister. I'll take care of this cart for Mr. Wes Dickens.
Come on, John. I suggest we beat a hasty retreat.
Right. Best remove ourselves from the stage before somebody decides they want their money back.
How is racing carts and horses supposed to help us catch Williamson? Where is my horse even at?
Well done, sir. Well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
Let me just fix the stream thing again. There we go. Horse. We can go see Seth, so we'll do that. Or Dickens is closer, so we'll go see him first. If this property is a rent property for rent or property for sale. It's rent. Okay. Won't bother with it then. Can a swindler change something?
Mr. Marston, sir! John Marston!
He's just trying to ignore him.
Don't be so childish. Come on, sir. I implore you. Okay. So I made a few innocent mistakes when last we met. But my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, then certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
You read my mind. I can only deduce you've been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
Sir, I am about to do something.
Good boy.
Which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act. For you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
What is this guy's problem? Mingle with the crowd until the show starts.
Friends! Hardworking souls of Plainview! Do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic, or inflammatory pain? Well,
we have an uncle that suffers from lumbago.
The only company that makes a genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
This man is a fucking
riding my horse,
or
he have this in
just
my
got
horse
done
to
swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take our business elsewhere. I apologize.
Why would they just instantly believe him?
Good day, one and all.
It's their word against ours.
Somebody get that thief back.
In your gun. Oh, just regular.
For Christ's sakes, John, get on the damn wagon! St. Homobonus has not been looking down on me favorably.
Who?
Homobonus, the patron saint of businessmen.
I'd say he's giving you your just desserts.
No, poppycock! Those inmates were clearly informed of my refund policy.
You can only shit on people for so long before they decide it's their turn to hold down.
A true metaphor in any sense of the word, my dear boy. You leave the business to me. Do I try to tell you how to do it?
What a guy! Robin Banks felt more honest than this.
John, you didn't even aim at him. My wagon.
For a man of the people, you sure ain't very popular.
I am up against the weight of plebeian ignorance, my boy. Keep that gun at the ready, my dear boy.
Maybe you need to think about a change of career.
I will never give up on science, John. That at me. How can these people harbor such bitterness?
Well, I ain't surprised. That tonic I drank at Ridgewood went through me like a dose of salt. no chance to walk away. What do you have to
do? My home screen.
Sean, respect science!
Respect science.
One less moron to worry about. Good job, I've got enough ammunition. My dear boy, you saved the day again.
It always impresses me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Yes, so perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Rathskeller.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. And forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.
We'll go see Seth now.
Seth.
Hey, John. Hey, partner.
You what you need?
Gentle drive his friends, okay.
Not quite. Not quite ready.
Should be nice.
You see, I wasted a bunch of time looking for that last bit of map. And I got to thinking, Moses was a liar. And I imagined myself doing all kinds of unpleasant things to his court. And then I realized...
Realized you were sick in the head? That you needed to move on with your own limited time on Earth?
No, partner. I realized Moses were no liar. The issue was Aiden O'Leary, who said he had the body. Aiden died in that flu epidemic, and the bodies weren't even buried yet.
Got the body sitting in the back of that wagon behind you?
Yes, sir.
Not even waiting to be buried before you...
Well, they don't care, do you, boys? Honest folk, off to a better place. Apart from that Aiden O'Leary fella, I never liked him. They say he lay with his sister.
Whoa.
I don't like women, partner.
But you were married.
Not since.
Seth, what are you gonna do with those bodies?
I'm gonna take them back to a nice quiet spot and look for the map. I needs the map, partner. I needs it.
Let's go! We ain't the only ones with an interest in these here fellas. Can't wait to get my hands on these.
Cannibals.
Find someplace quiet near Tumbleweed. I got a feeling the treasure's around there somewhere.
Nah, I can't drive. Back in the road.
Keep to the left. We don't want to roll through town with these bodies. Where are you? Come on, don't be shy.
What did you say?
I didn't say nothing.
Are you talking to them?
So what if I am? I feel less alone with them than in a crowd of people. The way I see it, they lost their souls, just like me.
You're truly a sick man, Seth.
You remind me of why I hate people. John. For a man who kills so much, you sure seem to have a problem with the dead. Well, I've killed everyone in the end. They ain't so different from you and me.
Aside from them being dead and rotting, I guess they ain't. All right, Seth, calm down. You talk to the corpses and I'll drive the wagon.
Oh my! It's them damn treasure hunters! Try and outrun them, partner!
That was nearly good.
Fast as you can, partner! Where's my map? Come on,
whisper to me.
Yeah! This fella had a few bucks on.
Good for him.
So, I guess this is goodbye. Are you hiding something, Seth? Oh, you naughty little boy! Will you be my friend? There's some bullets on this one! Better than a poke in the eye!
So much for a general drive with friends when you're being shot at left and right.
Somebody needs a new cologne. Well, look at this. Some elixir. Take a left! Figure this out. I'm gonna be rich.
When you're done with that, get over to Fort Mercer. I need you inside that place.
After I find my treasure, mister.
Let's go see Seth now. The dead bury
the
dead.
Oh, it's like that, is it? Huh? Not talking to Seth today? Oh, the old silent treatment. Oh, whoa. That's quite a stimulus.
Hey, Seth. Seth, come back here.
Oh, hey, partner. I was just looking for you.
Looking for me? What? Over there?
How you doing?
I'm good.
Well, see you later, partner.
Where you going, partner?
Nowhere.
Okay. Nowhere wouldn't happen to be where that thing you're looking for is kept, would it?
No, sir. No, sir.
Come on, partner.
Okay, I was just fooling. Partner, you know, the thought of that treasure does funny things to me. According to the map, it's somewhere in that big abandoned house.
Okay, let's go. We found a treasure in here before, didn't we? Oh, crap.
Check the back.
Can you shoot some guys so I can get some ammo?
Don't leave me, mister. I'll help you. I promise.
Yeah, I know. I'm just clicking ammo.
Here we go. Come on, Seth.
I helped you.
That's it, partner. Smoke him. That's funny.
Oh,
right to talk about things!
Oh, I think I found the treasure.
Don't torture me any longer. Get over here.
Yeah! Finally, it is.
I see the light at the end of this very long, long tunnel. Seth's gonna be rich after all these years. Woo-hoo-hoo! It's silk sheets and Parisian whores from now on, mister.
I didn't need to know that part.
Hell is this?
Oh, it's not even.
I'm sure whoever that belonged to treasured it very much.
Yeah, I mean, he wouldn't be able to figure it.
Those stupid chicken shit maps! Making a damn fool of me. A glass eye!
I didn't
eye.
Need to do that.
It's a glass eye!
Stop with the tears and help me with Williamson's eye. Gang. And you can come up with another excuse to go exhume one of your old friends.
Exactly.
Hunting dead man's treasure ain't done me no favors. Sure.
No.
Sure. I'm ready for the living. I'll see you and Mr. West Dickens over at Fort Mercer when you gentlemen is ready.
Oh, we unlocked a treasure hunter outfit. Well, what we need, we unlocked the steps on what we need to unlock it. Search Silent's Dead. Complete the California Stranger task. Make a profit playing blackjack at Rascally Fork. Claim a treasure hunter bounty alive. Complete Gaptooth Breach hideout. And then purchase Ed Taylor. I think we'll go do West Dickens and then see where we are from there. We're gonna find a way to get, figure out how to get out of this damn house. West Dickens. Oh, here we are. West Dickens, here to do another one of your stupid friggin' missions. The Spirit of Kings and Liars.
Mr. West
okay,
Dickens!
So gotta race a friggin' horse.
Ah, Mr. Marston! How wonderful to see you, sir. How wonderful.
Are we ready then?
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. Nearly, sir. I just need some cash to get some extra hardware fitted to my old Trojan horse here.
You what?
Never mind, sir. I can only presume that you have not enjoyed the benefits of a classical education, so I will not take umbrage if some of my illusions sail over your head, sir.
I won't pretend to understand you, but I will endeavor to make you understand me. Either we do this right now, or I put a bullet in you and get on with my day.
Please, I knew you were a violent man, Mr. Marston, but I did not think you were a stupid one. We need money to outfit my carriage.
Excuse me?
To turn a simple tradesman's vehicle into something more subterfuge. And I'm about to tell you how we are going to gain said cash. Now I know that you ride very well. So come, sir, to Rathskeller Fork.
Follow me, John. It's not too far to Rathskeller Fork.
You're not right, Chopper. There we go.
So how are you, John?
Okay, all things considered. All
right, boy.
Hopefully we can get through today without running into another army of your satisfied customers.
Upwards and upwards! I refuse to let the blind stupidity of the proletariat derail my calling
real quick,
in life.
We'll just do this.
Nothing blind about it. I'd say they saw right through you.
Before knowledge comes down, my dear boy.
Everybody knows you're as crooked as a dog's hind leg, Wes Dickens.
I resent that implication, John.
I wasn't implying. I was telling. You're such a successful businessman. What are you doing living in a cave?
Delightfully Dickensian, isn't it?
If you say so.
Are you familiar with the concept of philanthropy, John?
I'm surprised you are.
Oh, I don't do any of this for myself, John. I hope you realize that. It's been quite a ride, John, hasn't it?
We haven't gone that far.
No, I mean us. Ridgewood Farm, Gaptooth Creek, Plainview. We make quite a team, you and me. Brains and brawn. We should consider a more permanent partnership.
This partnership ends as soon as I have Bill Williamson. I appreciate your help.
Yeah.
But I've just about had it with all your scheme. You need to realize what's at stake here.
I know, John, I know. Just win this race and we'll be ready. I give you my word. There's Rathskeller Fork up ahead.
Horse race.
Go.
Go. I saw I was going towards our turn, tried to turn, but
let's go, my
yeah.
Boy. I'll show you the way. Come.
I'm just gonna ride there myself. Where even is he?
Come on!
Need him.
Yeah.
Holy show us the way. We got a GPS. Mini map.
Gentlemen, this will be a fair race. No shooting, stabbing, cliff pushing, rock throwing, cactus grinding, deck lassoing, setting fires, or other acts that causes a rider to unfairly lose his weight or bleed heavily or black out. Get yourselves ready. Set. Go.
Let's go.
got this. Fuck you guys. I hate the fucking horses in this game, and how like their stamina is so fucking weak. God, this is fucking bullshit.
Let's see what you're made of!
The horse's stamina in this game is such crap, such bad, so fucking bad. You see, it's fucking, this is so fucking, this is so fucking stupid. I hate the horse. Getting horse stamina in this game is fucking bullshit and retarded. It's like impossible to ride your horse and like, press A, get, like, press A, gallops like once and then, oh, fuck you. Good fuck. Fuck, they fixed that in RDR2. The guy swears that. They fucking- how?! The reason why I hate this game, and not this game, like, the horse game racing. This is the last race. Like, I fucking hate this. Horse, smarten the fuck up. Whoa! So fucking stupid. Yep, not gonna fucking police at all. I fucking hate this game with my horse stamina shit. I'll go to fucking shoot them and fail it. Yeah, because this game's fucking stupid with the horse stuff. It's supposed to be the fastest horse in the game, but fucking it's not. It's just shit. Shit, stamina. It's the fucking fastest. What's the point of fucking racing? Like, how's it supposed to almost catch Bill? Fucking cocksucker. Fucking hate how in Rockstar Games, like, when you're chasing enemies or racing, fucking, like, they make, you're chasing, like, NPCs and you're racing them, they make them have, like, 100% more speed than you do. It's fucking annoying. There we go. But they should not be that close behind me. Like, I have to wait until we hear, but it's so ridiculous how many people fail. Yet again. Got this time. Like I said last time, I'm in the same position as I did. My spinner motors have to be a dick. Okay, I got it. Finally.
He came, he
no
saw,
more fucking racing.
He conquered. What a fantastic spectacle, John. Let's take a moment to bask in the glory of our victory.
Have we got enough money now?
All right. Yes, once Seth and Irish have furnished their side of the bargain, I think we should be ready. Quite a team we've assembled, don't you think?
A bunco, a grave robber, and a drunk. How could things possibly go wrong?
$5, I guess it's worth it. I can try playing blackjack here. We get the thing for that open.
Easy, Parker.
There's people here, but there's no dealer. That doesn't make any sense. Alright, I'll go buy this property. $100.
You want to spend some time
with me? Let's load that save up. Blackjack is available again.
Hello there.
Alright, we'll keep up that.
Blue walls of fat. Muscles overbuilt like a smell of right. Blood and visceral.
Boy, you can afford this piece of fast.
You're not fun.
Hit me, please, sir.
Much obliged.
Hey there.
Howdy.
I got 16.
I'm all right.
Stand.
For Christ's sake.
Of course.
You want a good time?
Got an ace. Come on, give me a right damn.
I don't think so.
Hello.
Hit.
I think I could nab a little use.
You gonna poke me with your peacemaker, boy?
Got 6. Hit me. There'd be outlaws down there in them places. There you go, I got 21. should count. Is it? Let's see. It doesn't. That's stupid. Yeah, I just changed the stream thing here.
What a pile of trash.
Bust, of course.
That's what I like to see.
I will not accept this from anyone.
We got 20, okay. Different is, you know, the button changing is different.
Don't be shy, big man. Spend some time with me.
No thanks, ma'am. I'm not good with guilt.
I'm looking for a man like you. Need a woman like me.
God. Interesting. Bill Williamson's game.
Hate the gambling in this game.
Lucky bastard. Yep. That didn't work.
Surprise, surprise. I think the gambling in this game is fucking bullshit.
You can brand me like a steer anytime.
I don't think my dear wife would appreciate that too much.
Surprise, surprise. Uh-huh.
Hit me. I'm all right.
Are you lonely?
I hate this fucking... I hate the fucking gambling in this game.
Double down, late.
The bottle of McClure's I ordered from Spalding's still hasn't arrived.
If that's true, I'm the Queen of England.
That's kind of working with you, but I really gotta be going.
Round.
Farewell. Marshall Johnson's up.
That's nuts.
Ended up with the other crooks.
Yeah, one more.
Hey, handsome, are you busy? You want a good time?
I wish I could, but I'm married.
I'm staying, mister.
Stand. Thank you all very much.
That giant lion out at Hennigan's Stead is being protected by local ingrates.
Hit me, mister.
Card.
Don't be shy, big man.
I hate the gambling in this game. Like, it's so stupid.
I'm not here for that, miss. Interesting.
Oh, of course I got bust. It's always fucking bust. Like, it's fucking rigged, the gambling in this game.
That's enough, I think.
That's enough.
Nice to see you, Missy. It's a shame I can't see more.
Guess that wasn't my finest hour.
Damn outfit scrap.
Howdy.
Of course. Why can't I get this? Why is it so fucking bad, the gambling in this game? You get plus $7.
Looks like a lucky table.
John, it's fucking unlucky.
Are you lonely?
I'm staying, mister.
These guys?
I'll take one.
The life out of
bullshit!
You, boy.
Of course! Yeah, John, you said it is bullshit. Fucking gambling in this game.
I heard.
They say Marshall's going good down at Rio Del Lobo.
That's enough, I think.
A man like you want a good time.
I think I'll stand.
He's right here.
Not me, my dear.
Of course, yeah. The dealer got 18.
Well played. Double down? Wow.
Of course, the dealer got 21 and I have 20.
Let's clean this deal.
Like, it's fucking stupid, this gambling. The gambling in this game. Like, it's fucking rigged.
I'm staying, mister.
Marshall Johnson's up at Pleasant's house. Living it up with the other crooks.
Of course.
Unfortunately, I've got a wife. My God, you're pathetic, ain't you? Stick.
And it's 15.
I hope they get that new telegraph fixed. Do you want to spend some time with me?
Nice to see you, Missy. It's a shame I can't see more.
Not a lot of fun.
Well, really, sir, you shouldn't say such things in public.
Gotta go.
Why is fucking I hate this fucking gambling in this fucking game. Like, it's so stupid. It's fucking rigged. I want to get a profit. Like a positive profit so I can get the scrap for the outfit and not have to worry about it again. Not too hard to ask, game.
Why the hell not? Good luck.
I'll be good.
That's it.
Staying.
Hate it. Much obliged.
I think I'll stand.
Blue walls of white. Nothing sobers me up like the smell of blood and visceral.
You got some luck.
Of course. Holding?
Still hasn't arrived.
Okay, get me. I'll take one.
How do you do?
Are you lonely?
That's great. Thank you.
A man like you needs a woman like
you.
Uh-huh. Nice to see you, Missy. It's a shame I can't see more of you.
Wait, miss!
Why the fuck doesn't this count?
You're starting up around.
Like, why the fuck does this not count?
I sure did call him a cracker, right?
You don't say.
A certain marshal around these parts has been seen.
That's yours. That's what I like to see. You're no fun. It. What a pile of trash.
Like, this is so stupid, this fucking gambling shit.
Get me.
Her husband don't know.
I'm gonna double down.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Thank you very much.
Marshall Johnson's up at Pleasant's house.
And they say gambling don't pay.
Counts this time.
Right here.
Hey!
What the fuck, bro? This is so stupid.
What a place.
Sure. Hello. I'll join you.
Hey,
like, I just want to get this fucking outfit scrap completed, but the game's fucking retarded with this gambling
I'll
shit.
I'll have to politely decline.
Double down.
Stick.
Of course, you only got 19.
Well played, I guess. Uh huh.
I know that
I got 21 instantly. Yes.
You piss sitting
Marshall
down.
Johnson. Stay.
My favorite two cards.
A man like you needs a woman like me.
No, thank you, my dear. That's goodbye
nice
for me.
Nice to see you, Missy. It's a shame I can't see more of you.
Got a good blackjack game here.
Finally. Right, fuck off. Let's get the fuck out of here. Forget about blackjack. Save the game. And down to McFarland's ranch. Because I want to see if I can get something here. Let's load the games because I want it to be nighttime. Is it nighttime now? No. Load it again. Save it again. Here we go. It's nighttime now.
Sorry, partner.
Oh, sunset, but close to nighttime. Hope we can get the one. What's that there?
Who wants
my horse?
Next?
Just got rustled. Came from under me.
That'll teach you. You getting in or not?
No, I need to bring save this guy's horse. How far does horse fucking go? There it is.
Come on.
This isn't the encounter I was hoping for.
That thief changed his mind. Here's your horse back.
Thank you, sir. I'll pray for
you. I'm gonna just let my dog out real quick.
Mister.
Not you, my horse. Hey, dog.
Let's go.
I want to check my stats here. That makes no sense. We have zero profit from blackjack. Yet somehow it says we have a check mark under make a profit from playing blackjack. That doesn't make any sense. That's our logic. Well, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I am gonna end it here because there's some stuff I want to get done. But I am on summer vacation now, so streams should be more regular, and you might be seeing more of my content because I'm getting PlayStation in a few weeks, so I'll be on there and I'll be streaming some games over on there. And yeah, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you'll be up to date when I upload new videos. I have to deal with my puppy right now who's getting into my stuff. But until then, ride on.